गुड मॉर्निंग 11th स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे चैप्टर नंबर 4 और नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इन पार्ट 9 इज यस्टरडे वी कंप्लीटेड अप टू हियर. ओके, नाउ आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज न्यू टॉपिक, दैट इज ऑर्बिटल ओवरलैप कॉन्सेप्ट. व्हाट इज दैट? ऑर्बिटल ओवरलैप कॉन्सेप्ट. What is this orbital overlap concept? Today's date is 4th 9, part 9, chemistry part 1, lesson number 4. In the formation of hydrogen molecule, there is minimum energy state when two hydrogen atoms are so near that their atomic orbitals undergo partial interpenetration. Okay? This partial merging of atomic orbitals called overlapping, okay, which results in pairing of electrons. The extent of overlap decides the strength of a covalent bond. See, hydrogen this and this hydrogen, it is having one electron, it is also having half electron, one electron. So overlapping means one has this and one has this, they are having this charge, so they are getting overlapped, one has. Greater the overlap, the stronger is the bond formed between two atoms. So according to orbital overlap concept, the formation of a covalent bond between two atoms results by pairing of electrons present in the valence shell having opposite spins. Okay, see, 1s hydrogen, 1s hydrogen is so far, so they can't meet, but when they will come close to each other, they will overlap. Okay, and they will interpenetrate like that. So resultant is like that. Now we will more understand it by the concept directional properties of bonds. Now what is this directional properties of bonds? As we have already seen, the covalent bond is formed by overlapping of atomic orbitals. The molecule of hydrogen is formed due to the overlap of 1s orbital of two hydrogen atom. Now in case of polyatomic molecules like CH4, NH3, H2O, the geometry of the molecules also is important in addition to the bond formation. For example, why is it so that CH4 molecule has tetrahedral shape and HCS bond angles are 1095? Why is the shape of NH3 molecule pyramidal? The valence bond theory explains the shape, the formation and directional properties of bonds in polyatomic molecules like CH4, NH3 and H2O etc. in terms of overlap and hybridization of atomic orbital. Now, so after valence bond theory, we are understanding the concept, that is overlapping of atomic orbitals. Okay, now what is this? Now when orbitals of two atoms come close to form bond, their overlap may be positive, negative or zero. Depending upon the sign is called the phase, and direction of orientation of amplitude of orbitals wave functions in a space, that is figure 4.9. I will show you figure 4.19. In figure 4.9 shows sign of phase of orbital wave functions and are not related to charges. Okay, you see, orbitals forming bond should have same sign phase and orientation in a space. This is called positive overlap. Now what is this positive, negative and this? More we will understand from this diagram. This is figure 4.9, positive, negative and zero overlap of a phase on this page number. See, this, the orbitals are showing like that. I will more understand you. See, s orbital is shown by like that. P orbital having 3, as if you are knowing, no, in course you are having P. So this is Px, this is Py, and this is Pz. So by this way you can show. This is Px, this is Py, and in this direction is, sorry, Pz. Okay, now you can see the overlapping of P orbital to P orbital having the same charge, positive positive, means this is called positive phase. Now negative means one is positive and one is negative, positive and negative, so this is called negative or out of phase overlap. Now you can see the overlapping of P and S orbital. This is PP orbitals. See, we are taking Px positive and positive of only S is having positive only. So this one is S is having. Okay. So this overlapping is having the same charge. So this overlapping is called the positive. Now you see this positive and negative. They are having opposite charge. Means that is called the negative. Now in this way PP, both PP are in the same direction. This I showed you, this PZ, this one is of PX and PY, this one is PX and this one is PY, this is PZ. So overlapping in this way, same charge, so this is positive. In this way overlapping is positive, negative, negative, positive, so this overlapping is called the, for PP orbitals is called the negative. Like that, if they are in a slanting position, see, PX, PY, positive, positive, negative, positive. Now zero overlap out of phase due to different orientation direction of approach. See, S and this one is S, so this one is zero overlapping. More we will understand by one more example I will teach you. I showed you this negative, positive having the same direction, means positive. If the direction is like that, see, first of all you draw P orbital for one atom. If positive, negative, negative, positive, so this one is negative overlapping, this one is positive overlapping. 4.9 shows various overlap of S and P orbitals. Now we are understanding more with, see, the criteria of overlap as the main factor for the formation of covalent bond applies uniformly to the homonuclear or heteronuclear. Now you are knowing what is homonuclear. Homonuclear means H2, N2, O2, HCl2. Heteronuclear means NH3, HCl, like that. Diatomic molecules and polyatomic molecules. We know that the shapes of CH4, NH3, H2O in earlier valence bond theory, in the part 6 or 7 I taught you. Molecules are tetrahedral, pyramidal and bent respectively. It would be therefore interesting to use VB theory to find its, these geometrical shapes can be explained in terms of orbital overlap. See, we are taking one example, that is methane. Now you are knowing the methane, electronic configuration of carbon is in ground state, means no excited state, the energy is not applied. Helium 1s2, 2s2, 2p2, carbon 6. So first 2, then second filling, then third filling. Now in excited state helium, see, in this way also you can show. Okay. And 2p2, filling of 2 orbitals. This is vacate. So when excited state means when we are applying the energy, this will excite it to the vacant orbital of P. So helium 2s1, one orbit, one electron will shift to P. So 2s1, 2px1, 2py1 and 2pz1. Okay. So the 4 atomic orbitals of carbon, each with an unpaired electron of hydrogen, can overlap with 1s orbital of hydrogen atoms. So hydrogen is having 1s1, carbon is having 1s2, 2s1, 2p1, 2py1 and 2pz1. So carbon, this one is 2PX, 2PY, 2PZ, and this one is 2S. Okay, so 3, 1, 2, 3, and fourth overlap with 1s hydrogen, 1s hydrogen, 1s hydrogen, 1s hydrogen, 4 hydrogen molecules. But this is P, P, and P, and this one is not the P, this one is 2. So we will draw like that, okay, round shape. So 3, 1 P, overlapping of P and S, overlapping of P and S, overlapping of P and S. But this is overlapping of S to S, okay. But so results in formation of 4 CS bonds. Now 3P orbitals of carbon are at 90 degree to one another. The HCH angle for these will also be 90 degree. But 3 CH bonds will be oriented at 90 degree to each other. The 2s orbital of carbon and 1s orbital of hydrogen, as I showed you here, says 2s and 1s. This one is P, P and P, 3P orbitals with 1s, and this one is overlapping of 2s to 1s. The 2s orbital of carbon and 1s orbital of hydrogen are spherically symmetrical and they can overlap in any direction. So direction of fourth CH bond cannot be ascertained. This description does not fit it tetrahedral shape HCH angles of 109. Earlier I taught you know ki these are 90 degree. These are 90 degree, 90 degree, 90 degree, 3P. But actually the shape is tetrahedral and angles are 195. So it follows that simple atomic orbitals overlap does not count for directional character in CS4. Okay, so directional character of overlapping will be understanding by our overlapping of topics, types of overlapping and nature of covalent bond. I will teach you. So in CS4, using similar procedure and arguments, it can be seen that in case of NH3 H2O molecule, the NH bond and HOH bond angle should be 90 degree. This is in disagreement with the actual bond angles, which I taught you earlier, 107, 104. So how it will happen, we will understand it more by overlapping and nature of covalent bond in our next lecture. Okay, students.